In today's episode, I will show you how to model this simple house using Cinema 4D. Let's begin. First, let us start by adding a 3D cube to our scene. Now to navigate our scene, we will use these tools here. This one moves the view up, down, left, and right. This one zooms in and out. And this one rotates the camera view. You can also use the keyboard shortcuts. Press and hold 1 and you can move up and down, left and right. Press and hold 2 and you can zoom in and out. And finally, press and hold 3 and you can rotate the camera view. Now, if you press the button here, you can view all the different camera views available. You can see the perspective, top, front, and right camera views. I want to focus on the perspective view, so I will select this icon here to make it full screen. Back to our cube model. I want to change the shape a bit. Having our select tool selected, I will select these points and pull them out a bit to change the shape of the cube. Perfect. I now want to add segments to this model. For that, I will head over to the right side of the screen and increase the segments for my cube. You won't be able to see the segments unless you change your display settings. To change that, go to the display menu and select Gaurud Shading Lines. Now you can view the segments we are adding. I will make segments X 3, segments Y be 4, and segments C to be 2. Yeah, this looks good. Going to zoom out a bit. Now, once the segments are set, I need to make this cube editable. To do that, we need to select the Make Editable icon. Perfect. We can now edit our cube however we want. First, I will begin by spacing out the segments using the Edge tool. The Edge tool will allow you to select just the edges of our segments. I can only select individual edges by selecting on them or hold the Shift key and select multiple edges. Or you can double click the edge and you can see it selects the entire surrounding edges. I will position this row here. For the rest, I will change the view to the front view. I want to have a better look at arranging the rest of the edges. Select the corner box and head over to the front view window. Select this icon to make it full screen. Let me adjust this a bit more. Okay, I'll double click this edge and move it up. I'll do the same for the bottom edge. These will be where I will position the windows. I will go back to the perspective view. I'll select this window here. Now, it's time to raise up the roof. For the roof, I will hold the Shift key, select these three edges, and move them up. This looks good. It's time to create the windows for our house. For that, we need to select the polygon tool. Now, when we hover over the house walls, you can see we are selecting the faces of the segments and not the edges. Hold Shift and select these two faces. Here is where we will add our windows. Okay, press the right button of your mouse and you will get this menu. This menu shows you the tools we have available to model. Let us focus on the Extrude Inner tool. Now, all you have to do is click anywhere and drag. You can see new segments being added. This will be the border of our windows. You can also add a specific value here. Drag the offset bar and you will see it change. Sometimes moving the offset bar doesn't work. That's probably because the real-time update tool is not checked. You can see when it's unchecked, nothing changes. It's only when it's checked that the offset bar tool works. I will make the value 5. Having the two faces selected, I will right mouse click and select the loop path cut tool. I want to add a divider to our window. I will place it here. This creates a looped line around the house. Now, this bar that appeared on top controls the spacing of the line we just created. This looks good. I will leave it as is. Now right mouse click and select the extrude inner tool again. I will change the offset. However, you can see that nothing changes. That's because we have to apply the real-time update tool. Make sure that the box is selected and select the apply button. Now we can see our changes. I'll reduce the value. Okay, I want the offset to affect the faces individually and not as a group. For that, I will uncheck the preserve groups box. Perfect, this is what I wanted. I'll adjust the offset value a bit here. This looks good to me. I will do the right mouse click again and select the extrude tool. I will click and drag and push the faces inward to create our windows. This looks great. It's time to create our front door. I'll select the move tool to unselect the extrude tool. Select the three segment faces. I will change to the front view to have a better view. I'll zoom in. Now, with these three faces selected, I will use the extrude inner tool to make the door frames. I'll click and drag and, oh wait, this is not what I wanted. I forgot to check the preserve group box. Okay, perfect. I will adjust the offset to, I think 5 is good. I don't want the door to be that wide. I will select the scale tool and just scale the x-axis. Perfect. And now I will move the door to the bottom. This looks good. Let us go back to the perspective view. Now I'll create the door frame. Right mouse click and select the extrude inner tool. And check to see that the preserve groups box is selected. And click and drag. I'll make the offset 5. Now select the extrude tool and click and drag to create our door. Okay, this looks really good. Now it's time to focus on our roof. Our roof needs work. Select the polygon tool and select the segment surfaces of our roof. Now select the extrude tool and click and drag. This looks good to me. Now I am going to extrude the side walls of the roof. Select both sides and again right mouse click and select the extrude tool. and then click and drag. And there you have it. You now know how to model a simple house using Cinema 4D. If you found this video useful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Till the next one.